Ahoy, this is Zdenka. You have no idea how happy I am that I'm finally doing a little bit different video. Techtober was crazy. So many products, so many product reviews. It was quite intense. I'm really happy that it's over and I can go back to tutorials and a little bit easy-paced videos. Well, last round of Creative Camera Challenge was all about flat lay photography. And I have to thank everybody who submitted. You did a fantastic job. Thank you very much for taking your time and participating. It is hugely appreciated. And if you are new here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darula. If you want to learn how to take better photos and videos with the latest gear and possibly participate in Creative Camera Challenges like this one, consider subscribing. Let's start with a disclaimer before I'm gonna start reviewing your photos. Even though I've been shooting for 15 years, I don't consider myself the best photographer, absolutely no. Whatever I'm going to say, I might be wrong, I might be right. I'm going to review your photo based on how I would have done things myself. So take it if it's gonna help you, if you feel that some of the things I'm gonna say will help you. Leave it if you think that I'm completely wrong and it's not gonna help you at all. I'm definitely gonna take in consideration the level of photographer as well. Some of you submitted few photos. I chose only one per person so I can review as many as I can, so I can talk to as many people as I can. Photo number one, Raj Kumar submitted few photos. Here's the photo I chose. Bird watching. What I really like about this photo is the way you chose and arranged the items. They are complementary and tell a story. So arrangements are very well done. What I think could make the photo a little bit better is the cropping. If you crop the image a bit more from left, it would be a little bit better. Also, lighting could be a little bit better too. The binoculars are a bit dark to me. I don't see that much detail. I noticed that you use natural light, so basically what I would do, I would grab a whiteboard and simply bounce the light back. So I would bounce it back a little bit from the bottom left corner, so the darker areas are not as dark and I could see a little bit more of details. I'm loving the arrangements, they're really nicely done. This photo has been submitted by this user on Instagram. Loving the background, loving the items, choice of color. Everything is complementary, the arrangement is beautiful, simple, but it stands out. I'm loving that you just did it with something around the flower that gives that extra texture. The flower looks like a candle, isn't it? Very cool. I would crop the image a little bit from the sides, but again, that's me. And I would also make it a little bit lighter in Lightroom or when you're editing the photo in any program you are using. Basically, I would keep the brights and the highlights, but I would play a little bit with these shadows to see if I can bring them a little bit up just to lighten up the image a little bit. And possibly I would use the texture tool to give it a little punch, a little bit more structure in the items. Awesome photo. Thank you for submitting. Photo number three is from this Instagram user. You've got some treasure in your house. The retro items tapes. You know how hot it is right now for stock photography? I would just grab those tapes and I would be taking photos of them the whole day on bright backgrounds and different backgrounds and white backgrounds and I don't know what, and then I would upload it to stock and I would keep my fingers crossed that I can make some money. It is a very hot topic, so if you have items like this, just take photos of it and just upload it. I really like that you used the wood. It gives the old look. I like the way you played with the sun, light and shade. I really like that you pulled out the tape on the left one on the top. It gives such a great feeling to it. Really nice touch. This is just interesting shot. I don't know what else I would change. Really nice shot. What I really like that, especially in this round, you showed yourself and your personality so much through your photos. Some of you have been submitting on a regular basis and I'm getting to know you through your photos over the time, but especially in this round, some of you pulled out really personal or very special items which are saying a lot about you. For example, this one. Comment through this photo submitted by JF is learning leather work and trying to make watch bands. The photo was taken with Canon 6D with manual fill flash. These are very cool items, obviously very unique to me because I don't know how to do these things. I love the colors, the background really pops, good contrast, loving the way you arranged it. I actually like that it is pointing in all kinds of directions and it is not perfectly straight next to each other type of thing. It sort of gives me a message like you're in the middle of the process. Again, I would crop a little bit the image from top and from left to get more intimate feeling. Awesome job! I'm actually wondering if you're by any chance not making the watch bend right now as you're watching this video. Photo number 5. Violet, I've known you for some time now too. You've been always commenting on all those videos. Hi there! You submitted some amazing photos. This one though totally stood out because I guess we are both women, love technology. The title is All a Lady Needs. At first when I look at the photo and I saw GoPro and perfume, I was like, okay. And then I read the title, All a Lady Needs, and I literally bursted out laughing. Mainly because we are probably very similar. We are not the typical women. Okay, I love cosmetics. I hate shopping for clothes. I absolutely can't stand shopping for shoes. But for cameras, anytime. Not a typical lady you are. Love that black and white choice of items, feathers, fur background makes it soft and feminine. I know I'm horrible, I would crop it a tiny bit from top. Maybe not, it looks great. That GoPro there though, between those typical female items, just got me. Jürgen submitted this awesome photo. Why is this awesome? His comment to this photo is, I have to reveal a secret. I'm on that picture as well. Another special item revealing a lot about you. Let me zoom in on that photo in the photo. Let's see. So you are the little boy and those are your parents? Very cool. I'm totally loving the choice of the items, colors, the old camera, full look with leaves, just randomly putting it together. It works. The only thing I wish the crease wasn't there on the background on the right side, but otherwise, well done. Thank you very much for sharing your precious photo in the photo. Next photo is from Taylor. I hope I'm saying the name right. Another something personal, her comment to this photo is, taken with iPhone 11 Pro, roses from my garden as ornament. You obviously love gardening and those are very pretty roses. Loving the choice of the background. Colors go really well together. You're very good at arrangements. Great photo taken with smartphone. Payday by Jane totally made me laugh. I know you, Jane, for some time now as well, and I noticed your humor side from the past submissions. You should work for an advertisement agency. Payday on the chocolate bar and money in the background. Love it. So bold. Love it. What Jane says is, I raised the candy bar with those foamy things you put between your toes when polishing. Taken with Samsung S10 Plus and small LED light. There's a bit of a harsh shadow below the bar though. If you would use some whiteboard, you could bounce the light back to soften it a little bit. Also, I think you cropped it a little bit too much on the sides. I'm loving the idea and choice of items. Nick submitted this photo number 9 with iPhone 11 and edited in Lightroom. As he says, this is my second attempt at an edit as I thought my first one was too dark. What a perfect current photo. The mask in there is clearly showing that is now, that it is the way of traveling when you are allowed to travel, for now. Hopefully. I don't know how about you, but I'm finding those masks so uncomfortable. But hey, what can we do? Loving the choice of items which clearly say the story. Camera, map, mask, and book. 53 assignments to street photography. Love it. Simple and effective. Loving the right and bottom line. I would still play a bit with top and left side. Maybe crop it in a little bit. Or maybe move the objects. I really like it though, overall. Great photo. Revo took this photo with the title Living and the Dead. Taken with iPhone XR, he says that he took this photo on the way home in India. This is well done. Loving the framing, composition, colors. Loving the fact that the green plant is sticking out and is perfectly in focus. Knowing myself though, I would crop it a tiny bit closer from the bottom up, closer to the green plant, but that's just me. If you are happy with it, awesome. Beautiful photo. Irfan took this photo of, as he says, some old coins. 1975 is the year. Hey, that's 1 year before I was born. I have no clue what the currency is. Loving the vintage look. I'm glad you really raised the coin with something high to separate the background from it. You used water to create water drops on the coin. Loving it. Really interesting. I really like it. Nicely done. Next photo is from Kahaya. Loving the choice of background and the colors. You have some nice items there. Great tools. I like the personal touch adding the watch there. the shoes on the left, book on the right, and is it headset bottom right? I feel like it's a little bit too much. I would remove those three items and maybe crop much tighter to all those items in the middle. That is again what I would do, but otherwise, great photo. Thank you for submitting. Photo number 13 is from this Instagram user, Eddie, and it's just random items tossed around like a fall leaves. Loving the colors. I actually like it is not perfectly set up. I like that messy look. The left side is a little bit empty though. Either I would add another leaf or I would crop it a tiny bit. Loving the photo though. JC submitted this photo. These are such a unique vintage items again. Where do you get all the stuff? Loving the way you arranged it, simple and organized. I know that it's very difficult to find the right background for this. The wooden floor works because of the color, but I think it would be a little bit better to use something like old used paper, cardboard, sand colors possibly, sandy texture type of thing. You worked with what you had and you did amazing job. I would crop it a little bit closer to those items. I would not leave that much room around though. But that's me. Thank you very much again for submitting amazing items. Last photo for today is a crowd pleaser. You will know why. Let me show it to you. Sean submitted this photo saying, "Here is my setup for the day." What a collection. Look at all this. This is like a dream setup. Nice photo. Thank you very much for submitting all the photos. All of you are being credited below the video in a video description. Next round of Creative Camera Challenge will be announced later on this month. So subscribe if you are not subscribed already. Hit the thumbs up if you liked today's video. And if you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi or ahoy, you know what to do. Leave it in a comment section below. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.